Well, if there's one thing that every woman has in common, that is a heap of beauty products. From makeup to hair, our bathrooms tend to be crammed with them. Some we don't even use. So how do you make your makeup bag go the distance? Well, here with some great tips and tricks is beauty expert Domenica Calarco. Hello.
Good morning.
So you've got some great ways to get more out of our makeup bag, starting with brows.
Yeah, so I've got a few products that I know every woman would have in their bathroom cabinet. So sometimes, you know, our hair colours change and whatnot, so we don't have the right brow product to suit our eyebrows. So a great way of tricking an eye brow colour is just using a matte brown shadow. Uh-huh. And I love this Garbo & Kelly palette because not only is it an Australian brand, but it has some great shimmery shades in it as well. Ooh. So you can use that for eyeshadow. But there's a brown shade that you could just take on your eyebrow brush and use that to fill in the brows, which is what I've done on our lovely model today.
Do you really need eyebrow gel, or can you use a little bit of hairspray on the end of a brush brows in place?
Clever. Yeah, you can use that on a spoolie, or what I like to do, I do this all the time, is just take a little bit of my mascara and actually just use that to fill
really?
In my, yeah.
But it can't be black.
Blondes do not try this at home.
Yeah, blondes do not try this at home, but yeah, definitely if you've got darker hair, it's a great trick.
Hmm.
Yeah, and this Physician's Formula one's great because it's organic, so it's not actually gonna like hurt you or anything like that, which is great.
Okay.
Now, my massive problem in winter is my skin drying out, which I think everyone has, especially if you spend time outside.
Yes.
Do you need to change up your foundation in winter to something dewy, or is there something else I can do?
I mean, you definitely can, but I mean, everyone at home has a moisturiser or an oil. So what I do is mix a little bit of concealer with a moisturiser, and this is a great way of just making a tinted moisturiser for every day, and it's just going to give your skin that extra hydration.
And what about adding face oil as well to foundations?
Yeah, so I love the Salt by Hendrix oil. It's organic and it's an Australian brand. I mix this in with a foundation, which is what I did today. Mm-hmm. And
is that all you've got on, Gracie? Just oil and foundation? Oh, she's got really good
Gracie.
Skin.
As you can see, people think that using an oil on your skin is going to make it oily and, you know, you'll get shiny throughout the day, but it really just gives your skin that extra hydration that you need in winter.
And the great thing is you can double up with that oil by using it at the ends of your hair.
Definitely. This is amazing
texture
for your hair, on your skin, on your lips. Even like just you can dab a little bit on your skin for an extra glow.
Because we want our product to do more than one thing, right? But
definitely.
Why are women putting red lipstick under their eyes?
Yes, people are doing this. They're putting red lipstick underneath their eyes to kind of counteract the purple tones and the blue tones that we get under there. So like the dark circles and stuff.
Right.
Yes, I know, it's pretty crazy.
Obviously not just painting it on and
leaving it there. No, then you go on and, you know, you can put on...
Can you show us how it would work? Because that seems really bizarre to
me. Yeah, okay. So we'd have like a red lipstick. I have a beautiful Charlotte Tilbury lipstick here. So you'd put like a little bit of that underneath your eyes. And then going in with a concealer, a beautiful illuminating concealer, you just cover that and it would actually counteract any of the redness and the dark circle. And that's what we've done under her eyes today. And like you can't even tell we've got anything on...
I just thought you'd slept really well last night.
Yeah, exactly.
You have red lipstick under your eyes right now.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Because I'd be scared I'd look like I've got pink eye or something.
Yeah.
You know?
And a great little tip is this Charlotte Tilbury, magic wand. It's an illuminating concealer, so it does, multiple things in one. So it's great.
Mm-hmm. Now, talking about eyes as well, eyeshadow, how do you make that last the distance? Because I find different eyeshadows, some of them stone all day, some of them flake off.
Yes.
What's the tips and
tricks there? Going for a really good quality eyeshadow, I think, is great. Two of the ones that I've chosen today are the Garbo & Kelly and the Charlotte Tilbury, just because they are shimmery and people will tend to stick away from shimmery eyeshadows because they think they fall down off their face and whatnot. But a great tip that I like to do is actually use my finger to apply the eyeshadow. So I'm going to do it today. I'm going to take this shimmery shade, which is what they call the pop shade. I'm just going to get to close your eyes and I'm just going to dab that on. And by using my finger, it's actually going to place a lot more of the product and the pigment will show up a lot more on her eyes.
It's not falling off a brush.
And it's not falling off a brush. But if you do want to use a brush, you can just go and wet your brush a little bit with a little bit of water or eye drops.
Ah.
Not too much. And that'll just help the shadow stick to it better and really intensify the pigment of the eyeshadow.
Oh, right. Wow. The great thing about lippies as well is that they can have a few different uses, can't they?
Yes, I love the Humble lipstick. I mean, they're so underrated, not only for a great pop of colour, just to really, you know, vamp up your look, but as a blush. I love cream products, and I think for women that are a little bit older, sticking to cream products is going to change your life because they're not going to fall into any fine lines that you have and really going to give you that much more youthful appearance. So I like to use a more of a peachy shade. And I just take it on the high points of the cheeks. And by using my fingers, don't need any expensive brushes or anything like that. And the warmth of your finger is just really going to blend that product in.
Could you also use a lippy as a cream shadow?
Definitely. I do that all the time.
Always with your, would you always use your fingers though?
Yeah, for a lipstick on the eyes, I mean, these Charlotte Tilbury ones are amazing. Like, they blend like a dream and they last all day. So using a lipstick on your eyes is actually a great way to make your eyeshadow stay all day, even as a primer. And then you can go over the top with a powder.
Wow, so
one
product.
We've got our entire face now covered in lipstick.
And it's amazing. Lipstick everywhere. I love it. As, like, contour, lipstick, blush, on the eyes. Even if you had, like, a clear gloss, put that in the brows, you're done.
I feel like if I did that, I'd look like, you know, in The Simpsons when he makes the makeup gun and he's...
Yeah, like, that's... You can, but it's practice makes perfect and you can't go wrong.
Well, they do say that lipstick is recession-proof, and that's obviously for a reason. You can find Domenica on youtube.com/DominicaCalarco, or you can check out her Instagram page for more hot tips. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.